follow-up video to my first signs someone is thinking about you. There's definitely more signs than what I mentioned in that first part, so we're gonna definitely touch on that today. One thing that's really important to know is that these things really do exist, and the better, like I said, that you can start to detect them and realize that sometimes they're not even coming from you, is the easier you'll be able to kind of, in a way, live, because sometimes some of these signs can really drive you crazy. So let's get into the part two. So sign number one, reoccurring themes. I know for me, I always have this red robin that shows up at my windowsill, and it will sing to me. It will look me right in my eyes. And I know that that's coming from the person. So that's definitely a sign, but it's reoccurring themes, whatever is, I just use an example for myself, but it's whatever would be to your life. So let's say you and this person had a thing for butterflies, or maybe it's just you keep seeing something that's repeating. This is a sign that this person is thinking about you. And it's very important too that when you see the sign, you realize that whoever you're thinking about, whoever you think about right away when you see that sign, that's the person it's coming from. So number one, reoccurring themes. Sign number two, this one is actually the most craziest I find, and it's the songs. You will find that you'll almost get like a download of like a tune or a melody that like keeps repeating, or it's like a hook, the hook of the song. This will happen, and better believe that it could be a song from like, you know, 50 years ago that it's not even like your type of, you know, tune or jam, and you just kind of start like, oh goodness, like you have to find this song. It almost gets crazy because you're like, where did this thing come from? I don't even know this song. I'll give you an example with me. There's one song from that I probably heard only once because it was, or I only remember it once because it was a song from my parents' generation. And I was like, why am I being called to like search for this song? But I started searching it up, and then I noticed that when I looked at the lyrics, I knew exactly who it was coming from. So you'll find that songs will kind of get dropped into your head. And the reason for this is that there's something in the lyrics. It's something that speaks to you. It's almost like a message actually coming from the person that maybe they're not able to say to you at the time. But yes, songs is definitely one. Or if you had a song together, it could play all of a sudden, or you could have some freaky things like maybe you're just, your CD player turns on or your iPod turns on to a song that, you know, you two had together, or there was a thing about it. This is 100% a sign, okay? Number three, mood swings. You could almost say depression, but I don't want to say depression because it's not really even your depression. So for example, you're good, you're going about your life, you're actually maybe really happy one day, and the next day you just wake up with something and you almost are like, can't even detect why you're sad. So that's a big indicator, is that when you can't even find a reason to explain how you're feeling, it's definitely a feeling that's coming from them. So I would say mood swings, where you're good and then it's like you have one day where you're just like, they're on your mind, they're plaguing you, and you can't stop thinking about them. But then you wake up the next day and then all of a sudden you're okay. So this is actually coming from them. It's their depression. Not so much their depression, but their sadness from thinking of you. And you might feel like you need to reach out. You might feel like, okay, I don't know what's going on. Does this person like need me? You might have these kind of thoughts when you are experiencing this, okay? So next sign, let's jump right into that. Astral intercourse. Now, I don't know if I can say SEX on here, so I'm saying intercourse, but astral intercourse is definitely one. I know it's a little taboo to talk about this and it's a little bit like weird, but it's definitely a sign, and I can guarantee I'm gonna get a bunch of comments talking about that they had this as well. So when you're sleeping at night, you know, maybe you're not in contact with this person, but then you have vivid dreams of astral sex with them. And you almost kind of in a way wake up and feel like you just were there, or you could still feel it somehow on your body. So this is definitely a sign, because just like how it is here on Earth, for the most part, you need to agree on that in 5D too. So you two coming together, you definitely decided that you guys wanted to do that. So it is a shared experience. It's not just all in your head, and that person wanted to be there as well too. So yes, that is definitely a sign. Another sign, they show up when you need them. And this is a little bit of a tricky one in a way, because it's almost like, I'm gonna use my life for example. So anytime I've been really sad from something that happened in my own life, and I felt like almost like really, really terrible, like I don't wanna say giving up, but I almost felt like I just, it was like a low, it was like a really low, I felt really low, and I didn't kind of almost know how to come out of it or get out of it. This person would show up. They would show up in my dreams. Maybe there would be something there to remind me, maybe another sign, one of these other signs would show up, but it's almost like they're there for you and they show up when you need them. I don't know if anybody's experienced this, but this happens to me all the time. And it's actually quite sweet because it makes you feel like, okay, you know, this person is, you know, higher self, guys, we're talking about the higher self, but they're there for me. They still care and they're definitely thinking about me and they still definitely love you, okay? So that's definitely a sign with this one. And it's, this one might not be so much that they're thinking about you, but that they're there for you and they still very much love you and they care about what you're going through. So the last sign, let's talk about this. You just feel this overwhelming presence of being haunted. I know with me, this has been going on for 6 years now. It's like this person's everywhere, like everywhere. Can't shake them, can't get rid of them, never forget them, always there popping in and out. You know, you might have some time that goes by and you're like, oh, this is awesome. You know, I'm not thinking about them. And then boom, there's their name. And their name pops up when you're just like not expecting it. Or then you'll get like all these signs coming in. So you'll never be able to shake them. So it actually, I always kind of equate it to a haunting, but not in like, you know, a horror movie kind of way, like in another type of way, energy. So that is definitely a sign that this person is feeling the same thing. And when you feel this haunting, it's, they're experiencing it as well, because guys, energy is so strong. It's exactly the reason why when you call somebody, they'll be like, whoa, I was just thinking about you. This happens to me all the time. I'll reach out to people and they're like, I was just thinking about you, Melissa. And I was like, yeah, you know, I have a way with that. So telepathy, you know, you can actually start to master that. And it's kind of interesting, you know, the way things work. So we definitely are connected at all times. To people. And I want to tell you very, you know, if I could talk about anything in this video, nothing's a coincidence. Please, the universe is way too intelligent for this. So don't ever think that, like I said, like you're nuts or that this is random. There's nothing random about these signs. So thank you so much for joining me. I might actually do a part 3 because, like I said, there's more. So let me know what you thought and maybe include something, you know, that you, I missed out on that you would like to add as a sign, because there definitely is many. So thank you so much and have a wonderful day.